Hello, fellow researchers. I decided to make a natural test booster tier list instead of going over each one by itself again. I will review the compounds in a descending order and will be discussing only their testosterone elevating properties, since many of them have other applications as well. Everything I say here is based on science first and my own experience second, so let's begin. Fenugreek gets the first spot in the S tier because of the multiple positive researches which conclude it raises serum testosterone levels. Tomcat Alley, also known as Long Jack, gets the second spot here up at the S tier, again because of the multiple researches conducted with positive testosterone elevating outcomes. Honestly, both Tomcat and Fenugreek are equally as good in my opinion. When I had blood work done while I was cycling both of them at the same time, my luteinizing hormone, which in the endocrine system is responsible for signaling gonads to produce testosterone, was elevated just above the normal range, so that's interesting, but it's just an observation. Boron takes up a space in the A tier because of its documented SHBG lowering properties. SHBG is a protein which binds free testosterone in your blood for transport purposes, but lowering it means more available free testosterone. Horny goldweed takes a place here because I couldn't find hard evidence about its effects in humans, but there is a study done on mice and it concludes increased serum testosterone levels. Personally, I don't think that correlates to humans, but that's just my opinion. We need more research. I will also put tribulus here, a well-studied compound which has absolutely no effect on human testosterone levels. All the human trials conclude no effect on testosterone. An aphrodisiac effect has been documented though, and it's unclear why it's present, but it might be due to improved circulation through nitrous oxide pathways. In the last category, we have the aspartic acid, which has no effect on human testosterone, according to multiple researches, and I don't even know why they continue to put it in supplements, because studies have shown that over 6 grams daily not only does not increase testosterone, it decreases it in the particular control group, so bear that in mind. Maca also deserves a place in this category, as it definitely is not a testosterone booster and shows no such properties according to multiple studies. Also, in the last category we have DIM, diindolylmethane, which has been marketed as an estrogen blocker. Truly, there have been studies with such outcomes, but we cannot not take into account the fact that DIM is also a phytoestrogen, which means it's basically exogenous estrogen, no matter how negligible of an amount it might seem. And most importantly of all, DIM is an anti-androgen, which means it blocks androgen receptors and also blocks the mTOR pathway, which is necessary for muscle growth. So in my book, a big no-no. So there you have it, this is my take on the testosterone effectiveness ladder. I know there are other compounds with supposed similar properties, which I have not discussed in this video, but that is because I have no experience with them. But still, ask me, what do you want to know about next? Don't forget to comment, like, share, subscribe, and stay tuned for the next video. Peace.